Again, good morning to you all. My name is Mr. Salam Abdulrashid. I'm here to take you over financial accounting, and today's topic is balance sheet. What do you understand by the word balance sheet? Can somebody tell me the meaning of balance sheet? Firstly, before we go to balance sheet, what do you understand by final account in terms of trading accounts, profit and loss account, and the word balance sheet? Balance sheet is comprises of what? Trading account, profit and loss account, and the word balance sheet. Firstly, what is trading account? Trading account is an account prepared to determine our gross profit or gross loss. While profit and loss account, this is an account prepared to determine our what? Net profit or net loss. While balance sheet is just a statement. And in terms of the format, let me put the format on the board. Under trading account, and we have two methods of solving. We have the vertical method and the T format method. Under trading account, we have credit side, and we have the nether under, then we also have debit side. What do we understand by debtor? This is a person who owns the business, while creditor is the person to whom the business is owing. And firstly, under trading, we have our opening stock. Opening stock. Then we have our, if there is purchases, that is the goods you purchase during the business. You add it to your opening stock. If there is carriage inward, you add it, that's the goods you purchase after you discover that the goods are what? Fat. Then you have carriage inward. You add it to your purchases. After everything, you sum the three together. If there is return outward, you less return outward. If you less return outward from this, this one will give us COGAS. And what we understand by COGAS, that's cost of goods available for goods. Then you less your closing stock. If you less our closing stock, it will give us COGS. What do you understand by the word COGS? COGS means cost of goods sold. Then we have our cost of goods sold here. And in terms of trading, like I said earlier, how do we differentiate trading from P&L? In trading account, we said this is an account to prepare to determine our gross profit or gross loss. And if you look at what is on the credit side, we have our sales. That is the money we have during the month. The idea is return inward. You less return inward from this. If you less return inward from this, this one will give us, either you call it sales return, net sales, or sales return. Then from here, we learn less from the two. Which one is debiting and which one is crediting to get our gross profit or gross loss? It's not compulsory that in our account we must have gross profit or gross, it depends on the customer. And like the one we are solving, after we less sales from return inward, we have our what? We have our normal sales return, net sales, all over. Then you less it from cost of goods, so we have our gross profit on the debit side. And if you change our gross profit to this, it will give us net sales or sales return. Then the second part, we have profit and loss account. What do you understand by profit and loss? I think I've explained it. This is an account to prepare what? Okay, your question. Profit. Okay, what is profit and loss? I've said it earlier. This is an account prepared to determine your what? Net profit or net loss. Why in trading we have gross profit or gross loss? Please take note of the two. We have gross profit, gross loss. We have net profit, we have gross net loss. Then in this profit and loss, we have the normal format. All the expenses incurred during the month will be on the what? Debit side. Thank you. Clap for mama. Then we come back here. We have our profit and loss account. Then in our P&L account, account. For every debit entry, that is the principle of accounts. We have our biography CD. And in P&L, we say for every debit entry, there must be a corresponding credit entry by vice versa. Since we have debit side on our gross profit under trading, then to go to credit side of P&L. If there is discount received, you charge. Discount received, you charge it. If there is commission receivable, you also charge. Then you now come back to debit side of P&L. We have all the expenses incurred. E.g., we have wages and salaries. We have rent. We have electricity. We have carriage outward. ETC. If there is additional information that has to do with profit, provision of bad debt or bad doubtful debt, you charge it under your debtors. Any other question? No. Thank you. Then we compare the debit and the credit side. Which one is higher? The form will less. I think the credit side is more than the debit side. That's where we have our net profit CD. Net profit carry down. Then you close on the same lane. And also, in this account, we don't cancel anyhow. Please take note. In account, there's a way we cancel or we shave. Like now, if you're solving an account, we have the name of the company first. And if you want to balance, there is a mistake somewhere. Let's say you want to write 300 naira, and you want to change this to 500. It's possible in our normal subject. Like mathematics, you can change it to 500. It's allowed. But in accounting, please, it's not allowed. Please take note of this. You cancel this. Either you rule once, then you write it by the side, on the line, or through the line. Please take note of this. You write by the side, on the or through the line. Then the last one is now balance sheet. What is balance sheet? It's just a statement, not an account. Then the format of balance sheet, let's say the format of balance sheet like this. Balance sheet, everything must be in capital letter. Please, don't write in small letter. And don't put debit credit, please. This one is just a statement, not an account. Then we have four divisions of balance sheets. We have what you call fees, liabilities. Fees, liabilities. We have fees, assets. We have current liabilities. And we have current assets. Under this liability, without capital, there is no business. We all know what capital is all about. What is capital? In economics, we call it money. Why money in economics? But in account, we call it capital. What do you understand by capital? These are amounts supplied by the owner of business or money used to start a business. Then we have capital as an example of fixed liability. If there is net profit, that net profit will come under P&L because we arrive at net profit under P&L. Then you charge this to net profit. And if you charge net profit plus capital, you understand, if there is drawings, that is the money we withdraw during the business, like your personal use. We drew 100 naira for personal without telling the owner of the business. That one is drawing. Then you less drawing. And if you let's write under this, that's what you call capital employed. What do I call it? Capital employed. This one will give us capital employed. Then we'll go back to fixed assets. Under fixed assets, we have three aspects in terms of additional information. One, we have cost, we have depreciation, and we have net book value. And these three will lead us to these assets. Under the assets, you can see the plural. Under assets, we have fees and we have current. What do you understand by fees assets? These are properties that can last for a long period of time, such as what? Land and building, equipment, furniture and fitting, premises, etc. The other current liabilities. Example, we have closing stock. These are properties that can last for a short period of time. We have stuff, we have deeply on debtors, then we have our normal cash in hand, cash at bank. Then you go back to what? Current liability. Example of current liability is creditor. What do you understand by creditor? This is, creditor is the person to whom the business is owing. That's example of current liabilities. We have our creditors. After our creditors, if there is additional information that has to do with unpaid, outstanding, accrued, owing, then we charge all these under current liability. Then back to current asset. Like I said earlier, asset current asset are property that can last for a short period of time, such as closing stock, debtors, cash in hand, bank, additional information prepaid, /advance. Then you compare the two total together on the same lane, and you must get the same tutor. If there is adjustment to be made there, that one will give you error. And your balance is just a statement, not an account. And your two total balance must be equal. Must be what? Equal. That's all about final account that goes through balance sheet. Any question, please? No question. We are stopping here today. By next class, we move on to what? Profit and loss operational account under revaluation account. Assignments. Write short notes on the following. One, we have assets. Two, we have liabilities. Three, we have cash in hand. Then the last one, we have depreciation. Thank you.